Come on, Luna, pick up the pace.
You got it, coach.
All right, that's enough. Take five. Take a seat. What the? How'd you?
I'm just that fast. Ever feel like you could use that little extra something to give you a much needed boost in performance? Hey everyone, I'm Luna and you're watching QuikTIPS episode 7. Today we're going to be talking about DRAM and overclocking. Let's get started! Now, as you might remember from episode 4, RAM refers to your computer memory, which allows your PC to quickly store and recall data. If you haven't watched it yet, you can check it out in the description below. But what exactly is overclocking? Essentially, what you're doing when you're overclocking a particular component, in this case your RAM, is increasing its clock rate, which allows it to run at a higher speed than what it was designed for. This forces your RAM to perform more operations per second, which in turn increases the overall speed of your RAM. Okay, so we know what overclocking is, but what's the point of overclocking your RAM? First off, by overclocking, you're able to push your RAM to its limits and draw out its maximum performance. Almost as if you're removing the seal on your RAM and tapping into its latent energy. So you're not actually spending anything extra, but when overclocked, your RAM is able to perform at a much higher level than before. This makes overclocking pretty common amongst gamers who want to up their PC's gaming performance without buying new components. Not to mention, it's pretty much human nature to challenge our limits whenever we can. So it's not too hard to believe that PC builders or enthusiasts would want to test the limits of their PCs or components. Just like how an athlete would want to test the limits of their abilities at the highest levels of competition. Maybe you have an old component that's been lying around for a while that you thought couldn't possibly be of any use because of how outdated it is. Well, it's possible that some of those components can be overclocked to reach their maximum potential. So even old components can be powered up, in a sense, to deliver the highest level of performance possible. So all this sounds pretty amazing, right? Like, wait, I can basically upgrade all my old components without having to buy new ones? Doesn't that sound a little bit too good to be true? Well, something you definitely need to know about overclocking before attempting it is that it isn't without risks. First off, when you overclock a component, you're essentially increasing its operational voltage, which results in an increase in heat. This increase in heat gradually damages your component over time, which can ultimately reduce its lifespan. So it's incredibly important to make sure that you compensate for this increase in heat by proportionally increasing the amount of cooling provided to the overclocked component. Some other key factors to take into consideration when overclocking your RAM are clock rate and memory timings. Clock rate refers to the frequency of a RAM, which is more or less used as a metric for speed. You've probably seen this number before. It's measured in megahertz and is oftentimes written as part of a RAM's model name. So, the higher your clock rate, the faster your RAM is. Then we have memory timings, which is also used as an indicator for speed, but in a different way. These can be found on the back of your RAM stick, which looks like this. Unlike clock rate, memory timings refer to latency, or the delay between operations. By optimizing your RAM's memory timings, you're able to achieve a higher memory frequency, and also allow your RAM to run at its best. Since you're going for lower latency, the lower your memory timings are, the faster your RAM will be able to run. So knowing all this, how exactly would you go about overclocking your RAM? The first method, which is more suitable for beginners, is to buy an overclocking CPU and DRAM, and employ something called XMP, or Extreme Memory Profiles. This is a type of Intel technology that allows you to conveniently change between multiple profiles for various memory settings. This basically gives you access to higher memory speeds without having to customize memory timings, clock rate, or voltage, which, if you're a beginner to overclocking, isn't really recommended anyways. The second method is for advanced users who have more experience with overclocking. Now, this is a very important point. Please keep in mind that this is just a very general outline to give you an idea of what the process looks like, not a step-by-step guide to overclocking. Now, moving on, this method uses a manual approach that would have you first stress test your device to let you know what timings and speeds your RAM can reach. Then you'll have to open up your BIOS menu, navigate to AI Tweaker, and set your overclocking tuner to manual. Once that's done, you can start adjusting your values for settings, like speed and voltage. For voltage especially, it's important that you increase it in very small increments so that you don't risk straight up frying your components. As you gradually increase the clock rate and voltage of your RAM, the amount of heat it generates will become more and more of an issue. This is why it's so important to increase your PC's cooling capabilities using methods such as air cooling, water cooling, and liquid nitrogen to keep your RAM from overheating. All right, guys, it's question time. Now, if you could overclock yourself for 24 hours, so you've got super speed and super strength, what would you do? Now, I'm genuinely a little bit afraid of what kind of answers we're gonna get, but to heck with it. Leave your answers in the comments below. And that's all for this episode of Quick Tips. If you like this video, please give us a like and subscribe. And as always, if you have any tech questions, just leave us a comment to let us know. Thanks for watching. I'm Luna, and we'll see you next time. Bye!